सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, टॉपिक गाड़गे महाराज, स्टैंडर्ड थर्ड। हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम मीरा सिंह एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एन इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टॉपिक आई विल लाइक टू आस्क यू अ फ्यू क्वेश्चन, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, वेयर शुड यू थ्रो द वेस्ट फ्रॉम योर होम? टेल मी स्टूडेंट। Yes, correct. We should throw the waste from our homes in the dustbin. Very good. The second question is, why should the surroundings be kept clean? Tell me student, why we have to keep our surrounding clean? Yes, correct. The surroundings should be kept clean to remain healthy. Now let's start student. Lesson number 37, Gadge Maharaj. Student, Sant Gadge Baba was a social reformer. He was born on 23rd February 1876 in a washerman family in Amravati, Maharashtra. He lived his life in poverty and wandered to villages promoting social justice and initiating reforms especially related to sanitation. Sant Gadge Baba was the great hero of 19th century and known for his social services. He was a holy saint who worked for the helpless and poor people. He also fought against animal sacrifices and untouchability. He taught the importance of cleanliness and hygiene through practice. He also built numerous dharmasalas. Gadge Baba was a modern saint. He lived many years ago, but he still remembered for the great work he did in thousands of places. Student, today, in this modern era, the message given by Sant Gadge Maharaj is still worked as cause to inspire and enlighten the young mind. And also because of his great work, he is still remembered. What did he look like? Silver hair, brown eyes, fair skin, big, tall and stout body. He wrapped a lungi around the waist and wore a torn but clean shirt, a cloth shoe adorned one foot while the other foot was many times bare. Do you know children how Gadge Baba look? Gadge Baba has silver hair, brown eyes, fair skin, tall and stout body. Gadge Baba lived simple life and so he wears simple clothes like lungi, torn shirt, but the clothes were clean. If the shirt or cloth were torn also, but the clothes were neat and clean. Gadge Baba was so much busy in his work that he didn't care that he is wearing sleeper or not. Sometimes he walked with a bare foot. He always carried a bowl and a stick. Because of this bowl or a gadge, people started calling him Gadge Baba or Gadge Maharaj. His real name was Debuji Zingarji Janorkar. He never stayed long in one place. He slept only on a rough blanket and used only his own arm as a pillow. Student, Gadge Baba always used to travel from one place to another. He used to sleep on a rough blanket, which he always carried with him. And he used his arm as a pillow. He always carried a bowl and a stick with him, and this bowl is also known as gadge. So, because of this bowl, people started calling him Gadge Baba. But student, his real name was Debuji Zingarji Janorkar. Have you understood, student? Now, let's see the meaning, student. The first one is stout. Stout means rather fat. Then adorn. Adorn means decorate with. The third one is humanity. Humanity means kindness or consideration for others. And the last one is flocked. Flocked means gathered, come together. He roamed from village to village, spread his message of cleanliness, humanity, and importance of education. He was not bothered by hunger or thirst. Student, his teachings were simple. Offer nourishment to the hunger and protect the environment. Clean surrounding, self-help scheme, use of fuel-saving devices, increased environmental awareness, and strengthen of women groups are some of them. He always used to give message of cleanliness, humanity, and the importance of education. What he liked was bhajan, kirtan, and teaching people. Thousands of people flocked to listen to his kirtan. His kirtans used to be very lively. He would not simply give lecture. He would often put questions to the audience to put up their interest. Student, in kirtan, he emphasized value like services to humanity. During kirtan, he will educate people against blind faith and rituals. And he also used dohas by Sant Kabir. And during his kirtan, he also asked questions to the audience to keep up their interest. Then he will show them how absurd they were in their words and actions. For example, he will ask how many gods are there. Then the audience give the answer one. You worship Khandoba, Mesoba, Viroba and Vittal and so on. You worship many more, don't you? Then the audience give the answer yes. Your action shows that you believe that there are a number of gods and yet you said a little while ago that you worship one god. Were you asleep then? Student, through these questions, Gadge Baba want to know the audience that whatever they are saying, they are not putting it into an action. Like Gadge Baba asks them how many gods are there, they says one. But still they are worshipping Khandoba, Mesoba, Viroba and Vittal. Once they said that there are only one god and they are worshipping many gods, means they are saying something and they are doing something else. Now let's see the meaning. Lively means interesting. Lecture, a speech or talk to a group of people on a particular subject. Then audience. Audience means people who gather to listen to something. The audience will be taken by surprise. Then they will listen more attentively to the Baba. Baba will say, you offer things to God in return for his favor, don't you? The audience reply, yes, we do. And don't you say that if God lets go the two-legged child, you will offer him in return a four-legged animal? Audience reply, yes, we do. Then why can God, who created this world, be so cruel? Can he be so greedy? Can he be bribed? No. Do you think killing and eating one of the God creatures will please him? Will he bless you for that? Student, Sant Gadge Baba loved animals. He always opposed animal sacrifice. Since childhood, even when his friends, relatives and the people of his caste forced him to sacrifice animal, preferred to face their anger rather than killing the animal. That's why Gadge Baba always raised this question in front of the audience that if God create this world, then who are we to kill and eat one of the God's creature? We don't have a right to kill anyone, whether it's an animal or an human being, for our benefits. Then the audience will realize how wrong their thinking was. They would promise to be more thoughtful. After the kirtan, people flock to touch Gadge Baba's feet. But he would not allow anyone to do that. He did not like people touching his feet. As soon as kirtan was over, he sped away, leaving the crowds far behind. Gadge Baba always teach the view of community, sharing and giving. His teaching was simple. Give food to the hungry and shelter to the needy and protect the environment. And whenever the Gadge Baba kirtan over, all the people come together to touch his feet, but Gadge Baba did not like this. He always says that develop a good qualities in you. There is no need to touch my feet. Baba followed one rule to the end of his life. Wherever he went, be it a village, town or small settlement, he asked for sturdy brooms, spades and pans. Then he would sweep and clean the whole area. Soon other people joined him, but he did not wait for that to happen. Student, Sant Gadge Baba traveled from one place to another wearing his footpan, upturned on his hat and carrying his trademark broom. When he entered a village, he would instantly start cleaning the gutters and road of the village. He always asked for sturdy brooms, pad and pans to sweep and clean the whole area of the village or a town. He never wait for the other people to clean or sweep the whole area. He himself do each and everything without waiting for others. Now let's see the meaning. The first one is absurd. Absurd means not seeming proper or real. Then the second one is bribe. Bribe means to pay money to someone to make him or her to do something dishonest. Now the third one is sped away. Sped away means went away very quickly. He started sweeping and cleaning the place himself. And if any bystander tried to bow to Baba while he was busy in this work, that person will get a smack of the broom on the back. You do not do any of this work yourself, and when somebody else tries to do it, you put yourself in the way. Move aside. See how nice and welcoming this village looks when it is clean. Student, Gadge Baba get angry to the people who disturb him when he is working or cleaning the village. He always used to say that when you are not helping other people or when you are not cleaning your surrounding, then if other people are cleaning the surrounding, then you should not disturb them in their work. He always tell people that their felicitation would have to wait unless his work was done. If you visit a holy place in Maharashtra like पंढरपुर और नासिक और देहू और नालंदी, यू विल सी द वर्क गाड़गे बाबा डिड इन दिस प्लेसेस, घाट्स ऑन द रिवर्स एंड वाटर स्पाउट्स. गाड़गे बाबा हैज विजिटेड मैनी होली प्लेसेस इन महाराष्ट्र स्टूडेंट, एंड ही ऑल्सो वर्क इन दिस प्लेसेस. And for the betterment of the people, he himself work hard, asks for the people and build free boarding places like ghats on the river and water spout. Gadge Baba was a holy saint who worked for helpless and poor. For the poor, helpless, disabled and the needy, he started place that offered food free of cost. He built schools, colleges and hostels for children. He saw God in the poor and miserable people. Serving these people was his way of serving God. Student, whatever money Gadge Baba has with him, he built an educational institution, dharmashalas, hospitals and animal shelter. He remained a source of inspiration for various political parties and non-government organizations. And for the poor, helpless and disabled people, he also started offering food for free of cost. And he also built school. Serving food for poor and miserable people was his way of serving God. Now let's see the meaning. The first one is sturdy. Sturdy means strong. Second, bystander. Bystander means a person standing near but not taking part in what is happening. And the third one is smack. Smack means a hit, usually with open hand, given as punishment. And the fourth one is boarding places. Boarding places means places where one can sleep and eat at low cost. Have you understood, student? Now let's see, answer the following questions. So question number one is, what did Gadge Baba look like? And the answer over here is, Gadge Baba was big, tall and had a stout body. He had silver hair, brown eyes and a fair skin. Now the next question is, why did people call him Gadge Baba? And the answer is, Gadge Baba always carried with him a bowl and a stick. Because of this bowl or a gadge, people called him Gadge Baba. Have you understood, student? Now question number three is, what message did Gadge Baba spread? And the answer over here is, Gadge Baba spread the message of cleanliness, humanity and the importance of education. Now the question number four is, wherever he went, what did Gadge Baba do? And the answer is, wherever he went, Gadge Baba would ask for sturdy brooms, spades and pans to sweep and clean the whole area. Have you understood, student? Write the opposite words for. The first one is modern and the opposite of modern is ancient. The second one is always and the opposite of always is never. Then the third one is clean and the opposite is dirty. Then the last one is rough and the opposite of rough is smooth. Now, write the describing words for the following. The first one I have done for you and the answer is dash work means great work. Like this you have to do the rest one. Like the second one is saint. Saint means modern saint. Then third is dash shirt. So the shirt is clean. Okay. And the fourth one is dash blanket. Rough blanket. So I have told you the answer. So you have to write the correct answer. Now make sensible words by rearranging the letters given below. Now here you have to arrange the word. So the first one is UTRECAER. Now you have to rearrange this letter. So it becomes creature. CREATURE. So the correct form is creature. Now the second one is PIORSWH. So you have to arrange this, and the word is worship, WORSHIP. So the rest two you have to do on your own. Thank you, student. Keep practicing.